to Comcast Hometown Highlights. I'm Anthony Schultz. We are at Clayton Valley High School for the undefeated Clayton Valley Eagles against the Las Lomas Knights. The Knights come in at 9-3, and one of these teams will be playing in the championship game next week. Now, these two teams have a playoff history. The Knights have won both of those games in 05 and 03, and that 03 game was a thriller. It went into triple overtime. One of these teams is going to the championship game next week, and one of them is going home. We'll be back with highlights and some interviews right after this.
You're watching Comcast Hometown Highlights. Go Knights!
When you turn on your TV or log on to the internet, you don't see us. But we're there. We're the people of Comcast. People who love to bring you amazing technology and great entertainment. It's our passion, it's our privilege. So from all of us to all of you, thanks. Thanks for putting your trust in us and welcoming us into your home. We can't think of anywhere we'd rather be.
Club, a couple of big wins in 03 and 05, particularly in 03. What are your memories of that triple overtime thriller?
It was a fun game. I mean, both teams played to the end. Both games were close games. So, I mean, we're looking for a good game tonight. And, you know, they're well coached, and, you know, we're ready to play tonight. So it's going to be great.
They had a dominating season, Coach. You had a very good season, as usual, but a lot of close games. What's been the difference, you think, between these two teams? And they've been so much better than their opponents. And you guys have been able to win a lot of games, but not certainly in dominating fashion.
You know, we've been playing all year. We've been pretty steady. Our schedule was pretty tough. I mean, they're 11-0. We had a good, great season last year. They're on a nice little run right now. We're just kind of moving along, and we're in the semifinals. It really doesn't matter at this point in the year. We just go out and play football tonight.
You guys playing so many of these, it must be kind of old hat, huh?
We're ready to go for this. I mean, we're looking forward to this game tonight.
Coach, good luck. All right, I'm with Clayton Valley coach Bill Cockrum. An undefeated season so far for Clayton Valley. That must be awfully exciting. First time in the school's history.
Yes, very exciting. You're talking about a 50-year anniversary, and to come up big like this, go undefeated during the regular season, get our first big playoff win against Casa Grande, and now face a great Las Lomas team that's been perennially in the playoffs. This has just been a super and wonderful year for our students and our program, all our coaches, and the whole school.
After the 03 and 05 losses to this team, a little revenge on the mind for this guys, or is it just about the undefeated season?
It's about the undefeated season, although I must admit, I hadn't looked at the 2005 film, and I was part of that staff until this week. I couldn't bear to watch it, so hopefully we're looking forward. This is a much better team. We're thinking more about us. It's been an undefeated season, and we like to keep that going for one more week.
Coach, thank you very much. Our best wishes go out to head coach Herc Pardee, and hope everything's okay with his family, and good luck the rest of the way, and we'll hope to see you in the championship game.
Thank you very much.
The festivities would begin with a Nick Cole return of a Las Lomas opening kickoff. Cole would get the ball out to the Eagles' 32-yard line, and Clayton Valley would set up shop there, first and 10, to start the ball game. And here's that man, Nick Cole, again, taking a swing pass on the outside from Joe Levine. And another nice gain for Clayton Valley. Here's a combination that Las Lomas never quite did figure out how to stop. The Clayton Valley touchdown parade begins with his Joe Levine to Nick Cole touchdown pass covering 16 yards. And following the PAT, Clayton Valley would claim a 7-0 first quarter lead. Here's Calvin Sanchez lining up and kicking the extra point. The Clayton Valley Eagles were just getting started here in the first half. Here's Lucas Gordon now scrambling and showing his ability to throw on the run with a nice completion there to the sideline. And now with some improvisation, here's Gordon finding Deontay Jackson. The fine wideout makes the catch and run, good for 13 yards and a Los Lomas first down. The Eagles would stay hungry, however. They would force a Los Lomas fumble, and Holden Nakamura would come up with the recovery. Here's some Los Lomas defense. Despite being held, defensive lineman Morgan Breslin comes up with a nice sack. With the Knights back on offense, Gordon gets the ball to running back Marquise Waters, and Waters runs for 25 yards. He gets out to midfield on this nice catch and run. With the Knights trailing 7-0, they're looking to get the ball to their deep threat Deontay Jackson, but Ryan Nelson is running stride for stride to break up the pass. The Knights would continue to misfire. First, this Gordon pass is broken up, and then following a tip pass, Steve Stallone comes up with the first of his three interceptions. Running back Dosia Wagu gets into the act, running up the middle here for a nice gain, and a Clayton Valley first down. Nick Cole here on the receiving end yet again of a Joe Levine pass, one of seven he would collect on the evening. The Knights would clamp down, collecting their second sack and putting a stop to this Eagles drive. On the ensuing possession, things started out nicely with Gordon hitting tight end Darren Thompson, but another Eagles takeaway would keep Los Lomas off the scoreboard. More offense here from Clayton Valley. Nick Cole with a fine catch and run. And then it's Dozy Owagu with a sweep to the right side. He's able to pick up some yards. And then wide receiver Logan Dungalo picks up an Eagle first down and gets inside the Knights' 20-yard line. Los Lomas would put the brakes on this Eagle drive, but it's kicker Calvin Sanchez to the rescue to salvage 3 points and make it a 10-0 game. The Eagles D would continue to dominate. On this play, number 46, Paul Martinez would force another Los Lomas miscue, and that defense would translate into instant offense, with Owagu grabbing a Joe Levine pass, and 20 yards later, it was 17-0. It was an ugly night for Los Lomas. Already trailing 17-0, Steve Stallone comes up with his second interception off this Lucas Gordon pass. The Eagles' joy would continue. For the second time of the first half, a defensive takeaway would be followed by a touchdown. It's Levine throwing and Nick Cole collecting his third touchdown of the game. These short pooch kicks would give Los Lomas trouble all night long and really help to keep the Clayton Valley Eagles machine rolling along. with Las Lomas in desperate need of a touchdown. They got a good catch here from Michael Braswell. That would be followed by a couple of very tough runs from their running back Marquise Waters. Unfortunately for Las Lomas, it was the Eagle defense yet again, finishing off a dominating first half. With the Eagles looking to go up 30-0 here to end the first half, Mo Wilson turns them away here with an interception. Eagle dominance would continue into the third quarter. More of the same as in the first half. Steve Stallone, an interception. He would nearly take this one into the house, and of course that would produce more Eagle offense. Here, Nick Cole catches the ball toward the near side and then reverses his field, going all the way around the right end for a touchdown, and the Eagles now lead 30-0. We'll be right back. Knights would not give up. Here, Marquise Waters goes around the right side, gets a good head of steam, bangs into a defender, and finds the end zone. And finally, the Knights are on the board, trailing 30-7. Would also not give up. Here they force and recover an Eagles fumble, and just like that, Las Lomas is threatening to get back into this football game. The Knights' resurgence would continue. Here quarterback Lucas Gordon rolls left, and he finds number six Darren Thompson deep downfield, and all of a sudden the Knights have mounted a threat. A couple of plays later, on a fourth and goal in the red zone, the Knights' comeback would fall incomplete. After running and passing his team down the field, Lucas Gordon would scramble and find Deontay Jackson here for the final touchdown of the game. Deontay Jackson, after a stellar career in high school football, gets his final touchdown for the Knights. Victory formation for Clayton Valley, and they are headed to the Division II championship game.
Linebacker Steve Stallone, three interceptions tonight, very impressive. Did you have their playbook, or were you in their huddle? What's going on with that?
Nah, man, you know, just listening to my DB coach and my linebacker coach. Main thing, head on a swivel. That's what I did. I watched them, watched that quarterback, read their routes, and just jumped it. Jumped it like it was nothing.
11-0, running the table possibly next week. What does an undefeated season feel like?
Oh, man, it feels great. We got a good family behind us, good staff. We got our trainers just helping us out. We got our family sticking with us, our players. We work hard.
Offense is impressive, but that defense really got it done tonight. Talk about that defense.
Oh, man, our defense, everybody, when they cover their job, it makes it easy for the backers. We just picked that ball up, D-line, they shot low, got in. It's just all easy when everyone does their job.
Steve, congratulations. We'll see you next
Thank
week.
You.
All right. Good luck. Valley running back Dozie Owagu, a big night tonight. Talk about the offense and the way you guys move the ball. Pretty easy, easier than you thought it was going to be?
Man, it works both ways. Like, when we can't run the ball, like, it opens up the passing game. So when I'm getting shut down, like, the passing game's there all day. When the passing game's not there, then it's the running game. So it's like a double threat. Like, we practice hard all week, you know, and, like, I don't know, we just one game at a time. We knew Los Lomas was a team to beat, and, like, we got it done.
Is it getting kind of ordinary, being 11-0, winning kind of easily in a lot of the games, or does winning never get old?
To be correct, it's 12-0, but it never gets old. I mean, it's nothing more than you want to win. Like, you just want to win the game. Like, you want to be out here and have fun and whatnot, but winning is, like, number one, you know? Like,
what would an undefeated season mean to this team?
And it means everything. We haven't, this is the school history. We've never done it in school history. We're the first team to ever do it. It's 08. Like, nobody's ever gone undefeated. They've gone undefeated in the league, but not the whole season. Like, not like this. Like, this history in the making. History's been made.
Congratulations on a great game, and we'll see you next week.
Thank you. See me next week.
All right. Let's bring in wide receiver now, Nick Cole. A big game. Offense always impressive, Nick, but that defense probably even a little bit more impressive. All those turnovers. Tell us, how did you guys get all those turnovers tonight?
We had a good game plan with our coach. He had a good game plan since Monday.
Was Deontay Jackson a big focal point for the defense during the week?
We know he's his number one guy. He's probably the best receiver in the area, and I heard he had some injuries, so I don't think he's being able to play to his full potential.
What was that plan for him? A lot of double teaming?
Oh, yeah, double teaming, a lot of deep zone, because, you know, he likes the deep ball.
A lot of pressure in big games like this, but a little more pressure knowing that you're going for an undefeated season?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we've been working this since day one, and we're ready to bring it against Cardinal Newman.
Talk about that defense. Four shutouts already, and really they got that touchdown late in the game, but a bit of a garbage touchdown for that second one. So 7 points the rest of the way. Defense just unbelievable, huh?
Yeah. Our defense has been solid all year long. We got a great coaching staff. Coach Coakley, you got a good game plan. Good game plan for us.
Thank you very much. Good luck next week. With Clayton Valley coach Les Garaventa, the man sending in the plays tonight. The offense looking very crisp indeed. Tell us about that offensive performance.
Well, our offensive line had a great game today. They dominated, and our running backs ran hard. Joey Levine had an excellent game at quarterback again. Made some key passes for us, completions for us, and it was just a great team effort. Nick Cole was outstanding as a receiver for us, and it was just a great team effort.
It's obviously been a great year here for Clayton Valley. If you had to pick one or two things that really made this season go, what would they be?
Well, it was really the togetherness. The kids came together as a family, and that really had started early on, and even in double days, but it just grew and grew, and the kids just came all together. The whole coaching staff and the community supported us in school, and this has been we're like a family. Is great.
Tell us about that defensive performance tonight. Absolutely outstanding, huh?
Well, Jerry Coakley, our defensive coordinator, put together a great plan, and the kids executed it almost to perfection. Gave up a couple of touchdowns there late, but the kids played great. Linebackers, DBs, the line, everybody. It was just a good effort, and we executed the Coke's game plan to perfection almost.
Must make you very proud as a coach when the defense goes out there, gets a turnover, and the very next play the offense comes back and scores. You can't draw it up any better than that, can you?
No, you can't. And that comes in part that everybody was together. I mean, everybody was the kids on the sidelines when we transitioned from D to O, they were ready to go. And that's just part of the togetherness. We just play well as a team.
So it's not just about great talent. It's also about great coaching and togetherness.
Well, I tell you what. It was for Coach Party. He lost his brother today. It was tragic and sudden. And the kids really wanted to come together and won one for Coach Party, who's really brought this team. He's the glue. I mean, he keeps it together, has developed a great program here at Clayton Valley High School. And the kids wanted to get out there and do one for him, and they did. And in respect to Coach's family, I mean, they came through.
Yeah, this one's for her. Congratulations to Clayton Valley. Coach, good luck next week.
Thank you very much.
Off to the championship game for Clayton Valley next week for the Division II championship.
I've paid my dues time after time. sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicked in my face, but I've come through. And I need to go on, 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 on. We are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions. And everything that goes with it, I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before.